Hi everyone, welcome to Ejumalanga if you're joining us for the first time. If you've been with us before, welcome back. Ejumalanga developed 3 video tutorials for the Matric Mathematics syllabus of South Africa. Today we're working on the 3rd unit of the year. This unit looks at exponential and logarithmic functions, and today we're going to look at logarithms. Let's get right into logarithms. Logarithms are sometimes referred to as logs. So during the course of this lesson, sometimes I'm going to say logarithms, and at other times I'm going to say logs. I'm referring to the same thing. To understand logs very well, we need to remember exponential functions. So let's recall an exponential function. Our exponential functions would look like this. We had y is equal to a to the power of x. If you're seeing the exponential functions for the first time, there's a link to a video on this channel where we explain exponents and exponential expressions. So follow the link above and you'll be able to understand what you're looking at. Let's continue with logs. So logs are very closely related with exponents, and what they are used for is we use them to solve for the power portion of an exponential expression. Let's use an example. If we were to say 6 to the power of x is equal to 7,776, how would you solve for this value of x? Before, what we would have done is use an iterative method, and how the iterative method would have worked, we would have said, we know that 6 to the power of 2 is 36, 6 to the power of 3, we don't expect it to be close to this number either, so we'll start by doing 6 to the power of 4, 6 to the power of 5, and 6 to the power of 6, and we would have put each of these values in our calculator and solved. For 6 to the power of 4, we would have found 1,296. For 6 to the power of 5, we would have found 7,776, and then we would have known that x is equal to 5. But this method can take us very long, because we have to keep changing the powers until we find the correct one. And so if we use logs, we can solve for x in a much simpler way. So how do logs work exactly? I'm going to rewrite the exponential expression on this side. Y is equal to a to the power of x. And the log function that would correspond to this expression would look like this. We would have log base a of y should equal to x. So in the exponential expression, we had a base which is equal to a, and if we look at the log as well, we said log base a, so the base stays the same in the exponential expression and in the log. Our base is a, the base goes here in your log, and then the power or the exponent is what we're solving for in our log, and the power goes over there. The log function can be found in your calculator. If you pause this video and just look at your calculator to see the log expression, we're going to use it just now, so I do suggest you pause and find it. In the calculator, it may look like this. You may have log and a box and another box. So find this on your calculator and let's then use it to solve for this expression. So let me rewrite the expression. 6 to the power of x is equal to 7,776. We're now going to use logs to solve for x. Remember what we just said? We said that log base a of y should equal to x. So in this expression, we're going to have log base 6 of 7,776. Put this into your calculator, guys, so that you can see how logs work. And when you do that, you're going to find that the answer is equal to 5, just as we solved on this side. So logs are used to find the power which you have to raise the base by in order to end up with this number over here. Let's move on now and discuss the restrictions that are applicable when you are working with logs. I'll rewrite the log expression again. Log base a of y is equal to x. The first thing when you're working with logs is that y must always be greater than 0. So you may not put 0 for y, and you may also not put a negative number. If you try this in your calculator, you'll see that the calculator is going to write error. The next restriction is that a must also be greater than 0. So everything on this side of the log basically must always be greater than 0. There is another restriction also for a, and it is that a cannot equal to 1. So these are the three restrictions to remember when you are working with logs. If you put an expression like this into your calculator, all you'll see is an error, and then you'll know that you've broken one of the restrictions. Let's do a few more examples before we move on to look at the laws of logarithms. The first example we will do is log base 3 of 6,561. If we write this down as an exponential expression, it's going to be 3 to the power of something should equal to 6,561. And so the log is going to help us solve for this something. Put this expression into your calculator, and what you'll find is that log base 3 of 6,561 is equal to 8. And the last example we will do in this video is log base 4 of 1 over 1024. Again, as an exponential expression, this would look like 4 to the power of something, again, we don't know the power, is equal to 1 over 1024. Because we're looking at 1 over something, we expect this power to be negative, right? If you understand the exponential laws well, remember when you have a power to the negative, the expression becomes 1 over the base to a positive power. And so if you plug into your calculator log base 4 of 1 over 1024, the answer that you will get is negative 5. And so these were some quick examples to make sure that you understand logs. Let's move on now and look at laws of logarithms. Again, the laws of logarithms can be very closely associated with the laws of exponents. We're going to see this just now. The first law we will look at tells us that when we have log base 10, so when you have an expression where your log is to the base of 10, this can be written down as just log. So you don't have to write the base of 10. In your calculator, you're going to find the two log expressions. The first one will be log and then a box and another box. This box is for the base and this one is for the final answer. But you'll also have this one where you just see log on its own. This one is for log base 10. So if you're writing an expression where the log is to the base of 10, you can just, for example, say log 1000. And if you put it in your calculator and you use this expression, you'll find that it's equal to 3, because 10 to the power of 3 is equal to 1,000. So that's the first thing to remember about logs. The second law of logarithms that we're going to look at can be associated very closely with the product or multiplication law of exponents. So if we remember with exponents, when you had two exponents with the same base multiplying each other, for example, c is your base and a times c to the power of b. What we did was we added the exponents together, and so what we would get is c to the power of a plus b. As a log function, this looks like this. If you have log base c, again, we're keeping the same base that we had, of a times b. So these two terms are multiplying each other. What you then get is that you get log base c of a plus log base c of b. And so these two expressions are equal. That's the second law of logs. Third law of logarithms, law number 3, will again be closely related to one of the laws of exponents, and this will be the quotient or the division law. The division law states that if you have c to the power of a divided by c to the power of b, This can be written down as c to the power of a minus b. The law of logarithms that corresponds with this law of exponents is log base c again. And if you have the two terms dividing each other, a divided by b, that's equal to log base c of a minus log base c of b. And this is the third law of logarithms. The fourth law is again associated with another law of exponents, and this will be the power law. Remember, if you had an exponent c to the power of a and you raised all of this expression to the power of n, we said that what you get is you get c to the power of a times n. So what happens with logarithms is if you have log base c of a to the power of n, what you do is you take the n down to this side and you multiply the whole expression by it. So what you have is it's equal to n times log base c of a. And this is the fourth law of logarithms. The last law that we're going to look at is not going to be associated with a law of exponents. It's a law that allows us to change our base. So if you, for example, have a logarithm log base c of a, you can change this base and still solve for this expression using another base, using this law, and it'll be equal to log base b. So whatever new base you've chosen of a divided by log base b of c. So what we've had is we've changed the base of our log. We've started with log base b and kept of a. And what we've done is we've kept the same base, but we've now used the base that we had over here as the final answer. And this is how you can solve for logarithms as well. So these are all the laws of logarithms. Before I end the video, let me just write down some things that should be very obvious, but let's note them as well. If you have log base c of c, if we remember how the logs work, you have a base and the final answer after you raised the base. And so if you have log base c of c, it's going to equal to 1, because it's essentially explaining that c to the power of 1 is equal to c. The next obvious thing to note as well is that if you have log base c of 1, that should equal to 0. Why? Because c, which is the base, raised to the power of 0 is going to equal to 1. Remember, any number except for 0. So if you have minus 5 to the power of 0, that's always going to equal to 1. Or if you have 300 to the power of 0 should equal to 1. Anything to the power of 0, so long as it's not 0 itself, is equal to 1. So this log is explaining that to you as well. I hope you understand and that everything is clear and it makes sense. These are the laws of logarithms and some things to note about them. We've reached the end of the video. If you have any questions, please leave them for me in the comments and I'll try my best to answer them. In the next video, I'm going to do more examples, and I'm also going to do some examples that help us understand the laws better as well.